Hi friends, I have many things on this table here for you, things that we see in our everyday lives. So let's see, what do we have here? Here we have a piece of coal, chalk, pencil, diamond ring, lighter with a liquid fuel, candle, baking soda, sugar, and some vinegar. Do you know which element is found in all these things? That's right, it's the element carbon. We can divide these things into different categories. For example, in coal, graphite in the pencil, and diamond, carbon occurs as an element. So I'm going to group them together here. In these other things, carbon occurs as a compound, combined with other elements. We can divide these compounds into two broad categories, organic and inorganic. This is kind of a rough classification. Organic compounds are the compounds that are present in living things, like plants and animals. And inorganic compounds are the compounds that occur in rocks and minerals, or sometimes they are defined as the compounds that are not organic. So let's see which ones here are inorganic and which ones are organic compounds. Baking soda, which is sodium bicarbonate, and chalk, which is calcium carbonate, are inorganic compounds of carbon. So I'm going to group them together here. So here we have the inorganic compounds and here are the organic compounds. Vinegar is made of acetic acid. It's an organic compound. And so is sugar. The candle, which is made of hydrocarbons, is an organic compound. And the liquid fuel in this lighter is also made of hydrocarbons. So here we have all the organic compounds and here are the inorganic compounds of carbon. In an earlier video, we looked at the forms of carbon where carbon occurs as an element. In diamond, graphite, and I think the longest word in the chemistry textbook, Buckminster fullerene. So if you haven't watched that video, do check it out. In this video, our focus is going to be on the organic compounds. Now, do you know how many organic compounds are there? Is it like hundreds, thousands, or millions? That's right. The correct answer is millions of organic compounds are there. I think about 10 million organic compounds have been discovered, and still new are being found and synthesized. Yes, an important point to note is that organic compounds can be synthesized. They don't have to be naturally occurring. Since there are so many organic compounds, it makes sense to group similar compounds. There are many groups, such as hydrocarbons, alcohols, aldehydes, carboxylic acids, and so on. In this video, our focus is going to be on hydrocarbons. They are the simplest organic compounds. They just contain carbon and hydrogen, no other element. Now, where are hydrocarbons found? They are actually present in our everyday lives. For example, do you know what is the fuel used in buses and autos? It's CNG, compressed natural gas, and it contains hydrocarbons. What about the cooking gas? It's LPG, liquefied petroleum gas, again containing hydrocarbons. Petrol, diesel, these are all made up of hydrocarbons. And as we discussed, this candle and the fuel in the lighter contains hydrocarbons. So they are present all around us. Let's start by looking at the structure of some hydrocarbons using our molecular set. Here I have some models of hydrocarbons for you. The black balls here represent carbon atoms. The white balls represent hydrogen atoms. And these sticks that you see here, represent bonds. These are covalent bonds. As you can see, all the structures have carbon and hydrogen atoms only. Now let's take a look what is common and different about these structures. So let's start with what is common about these structures. That's right, they contain 4 carbon atoms each. But the number of hydrogen atoms in the structures is different. Another difference you may notice is that the first structure contains only single bonds between the carbon atoms. But there is a double covalent bond in the second structure between these 2 carbon atoms. And if you look at the third structure, there is a triple covalent bond between the 2 carbon atoms here. The hydrocarbons, in which carbon atoms are connected by single bonds only, like this, are collectively known as alkanes. This is an example of an alkane containing 4 carbon atoms. The hydrocarbons that contain at least one carbon-carbon double bond are known as alkenes. Our alkene here has 4 carbon atoms. It contains one double bond between these 2 carbon atoms, and the remaining are single bonds here. The hydrocarbons that contain at least one carbon-carbon triple bond are known as alkynes. This alkyne has 4 carbon atoms. It contains one triple bond between these 2 carbon atoms, and the remaining are single bonds here. A saturated compound contains only carbon-carbon single bonds. So all the bonds are fully used up here, and we say it's saturated. Unsaturated compounds are those in which at least 2 carbon atoms are connected by a double bond or by a triple bond. Now these bonds can be broken and something can be added. So we say that these compounds are unsaturated. Now which ones do you think are more reactive? The saturated hydrocarbons or the unsaturated hydrocarbons? The correct answer is the unsaturated hydrocarbons, because the double bond and triple bond can be broken relatively easily and something can be added. So the unsaturated hydrocarbons are more reactive than the saturated hydrocarbons. Here's a summary of what we have learned so far. Carbon can exist as an element or as a compound. Carbon compounds can be broadly divided into inorganic and organic. There are many types of organic compounds. We are focusing on the simplest ones, hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons can be divided into 2 types, saturated and unsaturated. Saturated hydrocarbons are alkanes. They only contain carbon-carbon single bonds. Unsaturated hydrocarbons are of 2 types, alkenes and alkynes. Alkenes contain at least one double bond, and alkynes contain at least one triple bond. Now that we are done with the concepts, are you ready for the top 3 questions on this topic coming up for you right now? Friends, try solving these questions and do let me know your answers and doubts by putting it in the comments below. I promise to reply to all your comments as soon as possible. So I'm going to disappear and you pause the video here and give these questions a shot. As we discussed, hydrocarbons are important organic compounds. They are used in our everyday lives. In fact, we are highly dependent on them. Fuels like petrol, diesel, they contain hydrocarbons. The cooking gas in our homes contains hydrocarbons. Do you know which hydrocarbon is present in the cooking gas? Or which hydrocarbon is used for the artificial ripening of fruits? And which one is used for making plastics such as polythene packets? Do let me know your answers by putting it in the comments below. And if you like this video, do share it out with your friends and family. And do remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel and like and follow my Facebook page. And do check out my website, manochaacademy.com. Thanks for watching.